you want to finally fix Minecraft, then listen to what I have to say here. Because if you clicked on this video, you're probably not happy with how the game's been getting updated and how the development has been lately. So a lot of people have been blaming the developers at Mojang for smaller, lackluster updates as of recently, but clearly that hasn't been doing anything, as has been made evident by still disappointing updates to so many people. But trust me, we can make a difference though, and in this video I'll be talking about how. So if you care about Minecraft, then this will definitely be worth your time. Because if we organize the community and show Microsoft and Mojang that we actually want to improve the game, then that means they'll probably listen to us. At least they're a lot more likely to than if people are just hating all of the time. And Minecraft having small updates lately is actually probably due to two reasons. One, a smaller development team than a lot of other popular games, and there's a lot of ways that Microsoft could fix that, but it's not the developers' fault. Instead, we should be putting pressure on Microsoft to hire more developers as a community. This could be a movement started that might be a lot more effective than just hating all of the time. So in other words, we need to start an actual organized movement, not aimed at the developers, but the higher-ups of Microsoft and Mojang, to hire more developers. The more people there are to work on the game, the more work can get done, the bigger or more updates that can be released like people have been wanting. Now, there are a few ways that Microsoft and Mojang could have the funds to hire more developers to work on the game. And the first option is that they actually take developers that have been working on side games like Dungeons and Legends that just failed miserably, by the way, after not even being out for a year, it's no longer getting updates. And that shows that people don't care much about the side games, they care more about the base Minecraft game. And we need to express that to Microsoft and Mojang, so that maybe then they can have the developers working on the base game instead. Now, as for actual funding, I'm pretty sure people would be a lot more willing to spend money on Minecraft expansions rather than side games that a lot of people just don't care about. Or they could just raise the price of Minecraft as a game. Now, there is another potential reason for the lack of content in Minecraft updates, and this is a theory that I've seen floating around quite a bit, and that's that Microsoft is scared of adding more major features to Minecraft because they don't want to ruin it or make it unpopular. And we need to show Microsoft that we're not afraid of having new features, especially when they can just be optional. So basically the rumor is that the developers can only add so many features because of Microsoft micromanaging every little thing that gets added to the game. So that's another thing that we should urge them to stop, is stop the micromanaging and let the developers work freely on the game and instead look at what the community actually wants, because at the end of the day, it's the community that keeps the game alive. So, if we as a community organize ourselves into an actual proper movement, that makes it a lot more difficult for Microsoft to just ignore all of us. So if we put enough pressure on them, we can get the game changed for the better, like so many people want right now. So, in other words, I'm urging everyone to stop complaining about the lack of content, and go and actually try and make a change by using our voices, because as a community, that's all we really can do. But if we're organized and less hateful, the companies are a lot more likely to listen to us. So now I'm officially starting the Save Minecraft movement, to urge Microsoft and Mojang to hire more developers to work on Minecraft, because a lot of people clearly care about Minecraft, and that caring seems to take up a form of hate nowadays, which is unfortunate. Blaming the developers is like blaming a cashier for a store's prices increasing. They have nothing to do with it. It's not their fault, it's their higher-ups. Still, with more developers and them being able to work freely on the game and make features and content for it, there is still hope for Minecraft to be saved. But that starts with us, the community, putting pressure on Microsoft to do that, because they have the power to. So please, share this with anyone you think is interested. We want to get this movement as big as possible. And that's all for now. I'll probably be making a video talking about what features could save Minecraft 1.21 next, so if you're interested in that, look for that later on the channel.